Okay. Partition rollover. Just close the lighter. Okay. Partition rollover now. Why we are using partition rollover? See, if you have only one partition open, okay, you have to, whenever you are running the full backup, you have to run the full one partition backup. Okay, now the partition size is 1 TB or 2 TB, then you have to take the 2 TB backup, right?
So,
I saw this one in NPK. They are closing the partition yearly. Okay, now their one partition is around 1.7 TB. I asked him how you are backing up, man. He was saying that it takes 4 days to back up. So the thing is, the better way is regularly close the partition. Okay, to keep the backup window smaller. Either 1 month, 3 months.
You will not back up the old
partition. Close partition, you can take the full backup and keep it for long. Got it?
So we close. keep backing up the closed part.
You can keep,
no need
for that one, because there is no change.
Exactly.
You can just take one backup and keep it with you, one or two copies of the backup and keep it with you for long. No need to backup again and again.
Because there will be no new backup.
There will be no new data inside that one. No need to backup again. So only the thing is, you have to regularly take the open partition backup. Correct? Then?
And for this backup that you take for the closed partition, where we have to define this? Means you have to set our backup product?
Yeah, backup product. You have to select like that. This is the closed partition. In the backup exec, there is an option like you can select it like backup the closed partition, backup the open partition. There is an option. Otherwise, you have to identify manually. Which partition have closed, identify the partition, take the one in backup, flat backup. If you are not using backup exec or net backup exec or net backup has agent for net enterprise gold. So it recognizes like partition is open or closed. But in case if you don't have these semantic product to backup, in that scenario, you have to identify which partition is closed, take one time backup.
Okay. So you usually configure based on time.
Sorry?
Based on time.
Based on time. Okay, then there is one term is collection. Collection is what? Collection is basically.
Whenever the base on time or what if like either time will reach this time or
should be on time, that's what
you can define based on that one. Either time.
But what is recommended? That's
there is no recommendation as such. Based on your environment, every environment has a different specification scenario. For example, for one guy, we saw that they are using SIFs. Okay. SIF here, /. IP and the storage, whatever the location is.
Okay.
They are saving on the network. So they have 5 TB or 10 TB. I cannot specify the volume over there. Right?
Yeah.
If the 5 TB is there, it will never reach that 90% of data on even after 5 years.
Mm.
Correct? So we can close the partition based on that one. The better way is after monthly or quarterly we can close.
So which option we should select?
No, because you know, it's said environment, like some of the customer, first week they have only 1 GB mail, then second and third week they have 5 or 10 GB mail. So
right, correct.
Select according to volume.
Yes, right. You only realize like once the archive run for the couple of months, 2 months or 1 month.
So this can be changed later?
Yeah, anytime you can change.
You can change, okay.
Okay, then the collection, file collection is what? File collection is, it will collect the up to 10 MB of email in one CAF file. And that CAF file will be saved in the storage.
CAF file?
Yes.
Kind of an archive file.
Archive. So, up to 10 MB of email will be compressed and it create a CAP file. That CAP file will be saved in the
storage. 10 MB.
Up to 10 MB.
Only up to 10 MB.
Yeah.
Sometimes some emails, one single email can be around 20 MB.
So it will be in the two CAPs.
Okay.
That's not a problem, but you
so
have
both it split on its own.
It splits its own. But the thing is, you will have a bigger file to backup. For example, now we have a files in the KBs if you don't enable collection.
Okay.
So in some scenarios, storage vendor is recommended to have the collection enabled.
Okay.
Because of the faster backup and those things. So it depends. Some environment they are asking for the collection, but it's a overhead to the EV server. Because EV server, whenever you are retrieving the file, it has to decompress the archive and give you the one email. Right? So this is file collection, click finish.
Okay, I just select on based on time.
Partition we have to enable or right.
Okay, if you see here now, this is our partition. The first partition. Yes.
For partition no longer we have to enable or not enable.
Sorry?
Not enabled. Self
enabled. Not enabled, not enabled.
I don't see if you either one.
Okay.
So, it's not error. It's not error. It's not error. It will stop. Do you want to continue? Yes. Because we do not have a role of
partition right now. The security errors.
It's different because you selected the different option.
No.
Now if you see the hierarchy, on the top we have a vault store group. This is only the defined term. This is our first vault store group. Okay, then we have created the vault store.
I'm stuck with something.
Okay, then we have a partition here. Partition is under the your vault store. So you can have the multiple vault store group also. You can have a multiple partition also based on the requirement. What we are doing is for the journaling, we are creating one vault store group for the journal, one vault store for the mailbox. Normally we are doing this one.
Okay.
Vault store group is basically associated one of the server, EV server. Now we have only one server. If you have a multiple server, while creating the vault store, it will ask you this vault store group is belongs to which one.
Okay,
remember vault store group belongs to any of the EV servers. Right now it's on one server, it belongs to this one only. Yes, tell me.
So you click next and finish.
So none. You don't need to select it.
No.
This is the collection what I explained you here. Finish.
Okay. So,
okay. In what scenarios would we have multiple vault store groups?
Actually, if you have, for example, if you have two EV servers, the storage is associated one of the server.
Okay.
Now this is associated to one of the server. This one.
So in a normal scenario, we'll have only one vault store group.
If you have one EV server, one vault store group. If you have a multiple, for example, one server is handling journaling, one is handling mailbox archiving. This is the normal setup we are doing. If we are implementing EV for the organization who is going to have journaling as well as the email archiving and user mailbox archiving, then we are putting two servers, two EV servers.
The one thing will mainly be required for the legal purpose.
Legal purpose, right. So
otherwise we do not recommend it.
No, actually it depends. Actually,
what is the requirement?
What is the requirement?
Okay.
So in this case, we will have the two servers, and we are creating the vault store, two vault store, because the vault store belongs to one of the servers.
Okay.
Got it?
Yeah.
So the second thing, in case of failover also, if you have two servers, you can fail over the services on the second server. How we can do that, we will discuss it later.
So HA is possible.
HA is possible in case if you have two servers. Or either the cluster, Windows cluster.
How will handle the store?
We have to attach it.
This is locally.